When Steel Talks, everybody listens.
And I know multiple musicians like Tom Scott, Greg Sack. This man does the music for the Grammys, for the Emmys. This man is a genius. We went to Japan together, and he heard Robert play. He said to me, "Man, who is that cat?" I said, "That's Robert, man." He said, "Jesus, he's playing this tune, Stardust." So he was saying to Robert, "That song is nice, but you only play it in one key." Mm-hmm. Robert didn't say nothing. The night, the show, Robert went up, played Stardust in a completely different key. Blew him away. Just blew him away. Totally different key. Totally different, nothing that he did the night before. Mm-hmm. You know, but Tom was like, "Ralph, remind me to keep my mouth shut next time." Told me, "Ralph, remind me to shut up, man. Tell me to shut up." You know what I mean?
He felt like you set him up. He thought
he heard something in that key. Robert dropped some new stuff on him.
Yeah.
In the new key, and he was like, "Oh my God."
God.
You know, so, you know, this is the kind of experiences that people have no idea. They still think of the pan as, you know.
And everything is happening outside of Trinidad and Tobago.
Well,
yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah,
you're describing, the appreciation, the wonderment, you know, that's all centered around the pan.
Well, if you're a musician, this is something new. We ain't used to this. You know, this is, where have I, you feel you're just a great musician, you want to know, where have I been? How come I don't know about this?
Funny. And I've heard that story many times, and over from people who have come upon the steel pan. Sometimes just by chance, and they're like, "How is this happening without me?" So many stories.
You
know, you probably heard a whole lot more than I have.
Oh, yeah.
But
that's the way.
Happens.
That's the way it goes.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's interesting. It's fun. You know, it's an awareness. You know, and it's nothing wrong with not knowing. But once you hear, once you hear Robbie, once you hear Bugsy Dunn play, you say to yourself, "Okay."
Mm-hmm.
Then you go on one of them balls. You say, "That guy's a joke." That ain't it. You know, that's not it. You know,
but
how many people get to see that, to see these guys?
Well, every time, you know, Robert goes out with Jimmy Buffett and yourself, and he plays these massive stadiums filled, you have a whole new crew coming on board.
I mean, in 1 year, at least 6 million people get to hear that steel drum. 6 million people get to hear
through
Jimmy Buffett concert that don't know nothing about Robert Greene, don't know nothing about. People ask you, "Ralph, where's Trinidad? In Jamaica?"
Yeah, you get that all the time.
I want to say no, it's not. Mm-hmm. It's its own country, so on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but they don't know, you know. And I mean, if you say, "You ever heard of Spiral?" "Oh, yeah, maybe." Well, you know, you should know Spiral, you should know Lord Kitchener. You should know these people like you know Bob Marley, like you know Stevie Wonder. You should know these people. You should know them. That's your history. That's your culture. Give these people their props. Even before Kitsch, before Sparrow, the Roaring Lion, whoever they was, and the other old timers, which I can't think of right now, but I mean, they said Lord Melody. Come on. "Mama, look up, boo-boo." If Harry Belafonte didn't sing the stuff, nobody would know about it. If Eric Clapton didn't sing, "I Shot the Sheriff," nobody would know about it. You know, everybody would say, "Oh, that's Bob Marley's song." "Oh, that's Bob Marley." Yeah, you know it's Bob Marley. But Bob Marley, the people that heard that song don't know about Bob Marley. They know about Bob Marley after Eric Clapton sang it.
That's it. And a lot of people
don't know. But see, this is what you go through. It's the same thing.
Same thing with Pan.
It's the same thing.
Same thing with Calypso.
You know, so you just have to let these people experience it and do it. You know, I mean, since I'm a little boy, I know about Pan, and I'm born in the United States, and I think sometimes I care more about Pan than the people in the Caribbean do. I think, because if you listen to my music, that's my music. I wasn't born in Trinidad, but my dad was born in Trinidad, and that's the legacy he left me. That's what I used to hear when I was small. Invader, Duke of Vine, you know, Sparrow, Kitsch. Oh, this is what my dad listened to.
Mm-hmm.
He was a calypso singer, so this is what we listened to.
Yeah.
Lots of Tito Puente, lots of Machito, lots of Latin music, lots and lots of it, you know. And then we was born in America, so we listened to James Brown and the Platters.
Everything.
And you know,
our
dad was a variety, you know, and that's the problem I have with the kids today. this one only want rock, this one only want rap, yeah, this one only want this, this one only want. And how you gonna tell me you like music? This is all, this table is music. You can't tell me, oh, I like this square. What square? That's part of the table.
Yeah.
You know, it's all different kinds
part of
music.
Mosaic, yeah.
So that's what helps you to grow. I mean, if you listen to my music, it's got pop in it, it's got rock in it, it's got calypso, it's got Latin. It's got all the different things, places I've experienced in my life.
And what's out there.
And that's what made me feel good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, and you get the feelings from that. So it's just amazing, you know. And it's the way I grew up. I love it. I love my heritage. I love the African music. My grandfather's from Africa.
Nigeria.
That's why I did this album, The Path, where I traced my family back through music. And the song, the record starts out like some foreign African thing. You say to yourself, well, that's foreign. And then you get to the middle when family goes to the Caribbean. And then it get a little beat and you say, okay. And then it goes on to America. And all of a sudden, you're saying to yourself, oh, yeah, that's the music we play here today.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, you realize, well, that's the same thing you heard in the beginning. You thought it was foreign. Now, when you change it up a little bit and put a little extra on it, you say, hey, that's disco.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
yeah.
That's to show you the evolution
mm-hmm.
of the family in terms of music, how far we've gone and how far we haven't gone.
And that gives us the opportunity to come back to mixed emotions where, you know, you have your son
well,
working with you and in Bridges.